Warning, there are a lot of Japanese names that I don't know how to pronounce in this video, so please forgive me. When someone asks me, what's your favorite song of all time?
What's your favorite song of all time?
This is a question that I've always found difficult to answer, and I've never had a certain way to respond to it. And depending on who you ask, they might not have an answer either. They'll just say their current favorite song.
Favorite song of all time?
West Side Guns, Julia Lang, easily.
Okay.
Right now, for sure.
Of all time.
Right now, for sure.
Like, bro. I like West Side Gun too, but come on, man. All time? Julia Lang, bro? Not even Mr. T?
Nike Max glow when I tiptoe. Fuck you mean I bent
toe. Okay, anyway. The gravity of such a question like this is, I always found it hard to answer. But now I think I really do have an idea of what my favorite song of all time is. Fishmans are a Japanese dub, reggae, dreampop-esque band formed in Tokyo in 1987, who would go on to be known for their psychedelic sound and their lead singer Shinji Sato's incredibly distinct vocals. Yes, I'm just reading off Wikipedia, by the way, thanks for asking. The group would go on to drop many projects during the 1990s, but their ultimate artistic statement and magnum opus is with the album Long Season. Not to get ahead of myself, but the studio version of Long Season is great. But in my opinion, it's just missing a little something. In 1997, they dropped their final group album, forgive me for mispronouncing if I do, Uchu Nippon Setagaya. But even more importantly, the group would then go to the Akasaka Blitz in December of 1998, where they'd perform all their best songs. And the show was recorded and released in the compilation album that we now know as 98-12-28 Otokotachi no Wakare. Now, you might not have listened to this album, but I guarantee you've seen this cover somewhere before. It's downright iconic, and whatever corner of the internet you run to, someone is gonna have this as a profile picture. Their performances on 98-12-28 include some of their best songs like O Slime, Smilin' Days, Night Cruisin', and undoubtedly most important, the live 41-minute rendition of Long Season. And every gripe I have with the original studio version of Long Season, the live version absolutely clears up. And it's their live version of Long Season that is my favorite song of all time. Now, unfortunately, a short while after the December 28th performance, Shinji Sato, the group's lead singer, died on March 15th, 1999, and it wouldn't be until a few decades later where the group had a late explosion of fans due to the rise of the internet, streaming, and music forums like Rate Your Music, albumoftheyear.org, and many others. But what really makes the live version of Long Season better than the studio version? Well, we first have to examine the five parts that make up the song known as Long Season. Part one is a slow start and absolutely rewards patience. It starts with guitar licks and bass, slowly building up throughout, and around the 5 minute or so mark, Shinji Sato comes in with absolutely heavenly vocals. The melodies also start to build, even if just a little, around this exact point. And this melody, despite going for almost 41 minutes, never overstays its welcome, and is the perfect balance of engaging and hypnotizing. Around the 9.5 minute mark, it gets very interesting because it calms down with the start of part two, then only to build back up again to an even better moment than the rest of part one. The melody builds a bit more, and then boom, it starts to peak. But then there's a guitar solo, which is absolutely crazy, and probably my favorite part of the entire song, if I'm being honest. Here, I'll play a little bit of it for you. And then it calms down into chimes, which play for about 10 minutes. And this is probably one of the biggest differences between the live and studio versions. Part 3 of the studio version is pretty weird, and a stark transition from parts 2 to 3, with just random breaks and solos and whatnot, but part 3 of the live version acts as more of a bridge to rebuild the melody and connect parts 2 and 3, as well as parts 3 and 4. This part, like part 1, really rewards the listener's patience. Somewhere during parts 2 and 3, the piano that's backing the melody disappears, but there are so many other sounds, you barely notice it's gone until around the 30 minute mark of the live version, where the piano starts to come back in as the only instrument, which is just absolutely ethereal. After this, the melody is sort of the same as before, but this time there are a bit harder guitars and other instruments, but most notably, there's now a violin, and I really don't know how to put in words how great this final 10 minutes of the song are. Around 39 minutes and 30 seconds, it peaks again. Think about that, a 41-minute song that gets to the absolute best at 39 minutes, and the song rewarding your patience really shows here, and it incorporates everything that was building up to this point, and I'm without words. Months later, I'm without words still. The song itself is incredibly enticing and can fit any mood. Happy, sad, depressed, not depressed, you name it. I was told by some friends a long time before to listen to Fishmans. Actually, one friend in particular. And as I do anytime someone recommends music, I just kinda went, yeah, okay, I'll get to it eventually. Which is unfortunately the way I still treat recommendations, and among music I've been meaning to listen to but haven't, there's likes of Car Seat Headrest, Godspeed You Black Emperor, Slint the Microphones, etc, etc. I'll get to them eventually, but I just can't seem to find the time, until a time opened up, and I finally caved in, and the first time I heard 98-12-28, I was hit hard by life, and the events of the few months leading up to it, and college life in general, relationships, all that kind of stuff. And I needed an escape, and I saw the album was 2 hours long, I said, why not? And then I let myself take in the music, laying down with the lights off in my room, only a small lamp to add to the aesthetic, and then I can comfortably say it lived up to all of the hype. Like, I'm talking about all the media I've ever partook to live up to the hype. This is absolutely in the top three, with Bridge to the Turnabout from Ace Attorney as number one, 98-12-28 as number two, and Berserk as number three. But when I heard Long Season all the way through, I was blown away, almost speechless, and it gave me so many feelings, it was truly incredible. The very next time I would listen to Long Season would be a once-in-a-lifetime experience. I was holed up in the room, I had a fever that was the highest I've had in a long time, I was wrapped up in a blanket and I stared at the ceiling and just turned the song on. The events from earlier that semester all came back to me, and I started ugly crying while I thought about what could have happened if I didn't make all the mistakes that I did, if I didn't push people away when they got close, and in general just some what-ifs. Which, by the way, are not healthy. And you should never think about situations like this. Because what's done is done, and there's no way to go back in time, you simply have to acknowledge it and move on. Doting on something you can't change like that would only stress you out. But at the time I didn't care, I was a mess, and I was sick. In general, every time I'm sick, I get very emotional. My roommate had gone to a frat to play D&D, which is fine. In the 4 hour span my roommate was gone, I replayed Long Season over and over again, crying, laying in bed, with God knows what illness, probably COVID. But I had no idea, but nothing had hit me that hard in a long time. And by the final Long Season rerun toward the very end, I came to terms with the fact that I couldn't change what happened, with all the mistakes I made and the people I pushed away. And I was able to calm down, and my temperature had gone down right about the same time as well. It was as if whatever had ailed me was something mental that had gone on to affect my entire body almost. And I don't really know how to describe it, but this incredible piece of music had given me an almost religious-like experience, and the strength and motivation to move on from what was holding me back. And as was told to me by the people I knew who said I absolutely had to listen to this album, I'm going to pass on their words to you. If you have an hour, give or take, you probably can't listen to 98-12-28, but what you can do is listen to the live version of Long Season. And it's the live version of Long Season that I can comfortably say is my favorite song of all time. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, like the video. Please subscribe, hit the bell, tell your friends, I don't know man, do it, or don't. I don't fucking care. Have a good one, fellas.